Happy Mercedesing! Welcome to the Q&A video. As a vast majority of you wanted this to be a regular video and not live, then here. Before I start, I would like to greet some people, some members. I would like to greet some new members on the channel, like Yanis Karalabidis, my dear, please. BHF Art, my dear. Muhammad Kalpamak, my dear. Alexander Zhelyazov, my dear. Yura Raipanhal, you know. Auto Village, yes, yes. Trevor Ross, as well as Lockery, my longest member on the channel. My dears, please. I would also like to thank myself to Helmer van Greven, my dears. Thanks for your donation. Happy Mercedesing. And now let's go to the Q&As video. Shall we? Question number one. My car is 190E and 102 engine. It's hard to start. The gas pressure is not holding. What are the reasons? If the gas pressure is not holding, then you have either a bad fuel pump or a bad fuel pressure regulator. You must check both of them. If the pump delivers at least 1 liter in 40 seconds, but the pressure drops to zero the moment you turn off the car, then you have a bad check valve. Replace it if this is the case. They are cheap. The values you should get for your car are 5.5 bar system pressure and 5.1 control pressure. Replace the fuel filter on the feed the line just in case you haven't and the fuel filter itself. Use Knecht Male KL19 for your car. As for the little filter on the feed line, I will leave you the link here. If the car is difficult to start warm, replace the fuel accumulator. Question number two.
Hola. Muy buen video, yo ya cambié el acumulador y sigue sin arrancar bien en caliente. Voy a preparar los manómetros para mi motor M102. Ahora me indicas a dónde está la válvula de retención. Muchas gracias.
Eso es la válvula de retención. Como ya dice, es muy barata.
Question number three.
Hello, the EHA valve.
How deep should it be in millimeters? Because I ordered a new gasket and I think I tightened it too much because of the high fuel consumption. The depth of the 2 mils Allen inside the EHA valve should be approximately 6.6 mils. My recommendation to you is to hook up the pressure gauge and do fine adjustments until you get the differential pressure of 0.4 bar. In order to get it in specs, you would have to measure milliamps on it. Once you get the fluctuation between negative 3 and 0 milliamps, you are in specs. The range can go up to 3 milliamps. Negative amperage, mixture rich. Positive amperage, mixture lean. If you have no lambda, you will have to get the value up to negative 2 milliamps once the car is warm. The link to how milliamps are being measured. Question number 4. The question I get very often. This is actually not a question, this is a request. Give me your phone number. Okay, bear in mind that I charge these phone calls if you want to talk to me. I've been speaking about this, so this must be charged. Bear that in mind. Everything I know, I said in my videos, and I'm still speaking about that. All my videos are free of charge. If I have to talk to everybody who contacts me on Instagram, YouTube, primarily on Instagram, what did I make the videos for? Now I am asking you. If you are not willing to pay, I can give you links to the videos you need for your car to be repaired. And the videos are, as I have already said, free of charge. Now I'm going to repeat this question in Serbian, because in Serbia, I get this request. Čest zahtev koji dobijem je daj mi broj telefona. Kao prvo. Što se toga tiče, već sam pričao o tome. Svako kome budem dao broj telefona moraće da mi plati. Razgovori sa mnom se naplaćuju. Evo zašto je to tako. Sve što sam ja pričao i o čemu sam pričao na YouTube-u i na kanalu, svi moji videi su gratis. Kompletno. Svi gratis. E sad, pazite situaciju. Sad kad da krene svako da me pita i da me zove, mislim, ja to doživljavam. Evo, vi me razuverite da nije tako. Ja ovo doživljavam kao situaciju ko će preko hleba pogaču. Dakle, kad vidi da moj video traje pola sata, e onda kao, a šta ću sad da se cimam, da gledam, daj lepo ću da zovnem čoveka i on će da mi ispriča. A čekaj, zašto se ja cimam onda da snimam videe? Pitam ja vas. Zbog čega? Zbog čega se cimam? Nije ovo lako, ni malo koliko vi mislite. Samo je, a lako, tebi ne treba ti ni skupa kamera, ništa, uzmeš telefon, klikneš snimaj i kreneš da se snimaš. Nije baš tako jednostavno. Ja izgubim posle vreme i vreme, sate u montiranju. Nije tako lako. Iako malo ima videa na srpskom jeziku.
ima ih I dovoljno je da možete da popravite kola. Zbog toga ja naplaćujem razgovore sa mnom. Jer ako ja vama ispričam I kažem sve ono što sam pričao u videima, pa zašto ja snimam vide? Zbog čega? Hajde, recite mi. Tako da, eto, ako me budete pitali za nadalje, pošto su gratis videi, ja mogu samo da vam dam linkove, pa gledajte videe. Znači, ako je problem, na primjer, TPS, dobijaš link. Tu ti je problem. Ako ti je problem, na primjer, šta ja znam, opet, EH ventil, dobijaš link. I gledaj. Ako hoćeš sa mnom da pričaš, moraš da platiš. E, u tome je razlika. Hvala na razumevanju.
Question number 5.
Hi, I'm following you from Italy. I wanted to share my problem with you. I can't get it to run well on petrol. It vibrates all over and has difficulty picking up speed. Can you help me? Thanks. If you have mounted LPG as well, then I can't help. My videos help only those who run their cars on petrol only. Check the whole mechanical system. That's what I can tell you. Here is the link to that video.
Question number 6.
Hello. I have M102.985 2.3 liter Ke-Jetronic. And I have one issue. It idles normally at 1K, but idles very rich and cold starts hardly sometimes. At drive and the high RPM, it runs very good. There are many reasons for difficult cold starts. Bad cold start valve, bad coolant temperature sensor, or bad OVP. For now, check the coolant temperature sensor on resistance whether it is in specs or not. Check the sensor twice, once the engine is cold and when it is warm. Check the OVP whether you have voltage on pin 1. Check if you have continuity on pin 31 on the OVP. Check the ground on pin 20 on the ECU. This way you will know if the ECU is working or not. Replace the injectors if you haven't, and check the voltage on X11.
Question number 7.
This question is about the E220. This engine is the LH-Jetronic, and that's not my field of interest. I do videos on Ke-Jetronic. Basically, you will have to replace the lambda, clean the mass airflow sensor with a cleaner for it. So you buy the mass airflow sensor cleaner, not carb cleaner, not brake cleaner, but especially the cleaner for mass airflow sensors. And then remove it and clean it. Wash the injectors in the ultrasonic bath. And that's as much as I can tell.
And the final question.
Can the lambda be checked with an electrical meter? Yes, it can, but I don't recommend it. If you have more than 60K kilometers on the clock. In this case, it was 330
32K. So don't bother yourself checking it. In this case, it had to be replaced at least 5 times. So, if you liked this video,
please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
Then, I would kindly ask you not to hit the button skip ad. That is going to help me a lot. And till some next one, happy Mercedesing. Bye.